So we get t equal to 0. When we put t equal to infinity, we get e raised to infinity equal to t, so t will be infinity. So now if you see, our limits of integration are from 0 to infinity, which is matching with beta of m comma n integration. So we get I equal to integration of 0 to infinity. Here it is x, so dx will be log of t. Derivative of log of t is 1 by t, so 1 upon 2t into dt. So e raised to n x, e raised to n x is this term, that is 1 upon 2 log t, upon e raised to 2x is t, so 1 plus t the whole raised to n into dx, dx is this term, that is 1 upon 2t dt. We know the property of log, that is 3 log x is nothing but log of x cube. So that is, this 3 can be taken in the power of x. So we will take this n by 2 in the power of t, so it will be t raised to n by 2. And we know that e raised to log of x is nothing but x, that is this term. So similarly, e raised to log of t raised to n by 2 will be nothing but t raised to n by 2. Integration of 0 to infinity, and in the denominator we have 1 plus t the whole raised to n. This t, when goes in the numerator, it will be t raised to minus 1. So this t and this t will be combined and we get n by 2 minus 1 into dt. And this 2 is constant, we can take it out of the integration, so it will be 1 upon 2. And here we have missed one thing. Here we are writing half. So this half is already present. So here it will be half. Here also it will be half. So this half will be multiplied by this 2, so it will be 1 upon 4. So now if you compare this term with this term, both these terms are similar. So our m minus 1 will be n by 2 minus 1, so m is n by 2. And m plus n dash, say this is n dash and it is beta of m comma n dash. So m plus n dash is nothing but this n. So n dash will be n minus m, m is n by 2, so n dash is nothing but n by 2. So this is beta of m comma n dash. So this is nothing but beta of n by 2 comma n by 2. So our final I is nothing but 1 upon 4 beta of n by 2 comma n by 2. Now if you see our question, we also wanted this thing, that is 1 by 4 beta of n comma 2 comma beta of n by 2 comma n by 2. So this term is equivalent to left hand side, hence proof. So but our question is not over yet. We have proved this thing, and by using this proof we have to calculate integration of sec hyperbolic x the whole raised to it dx. So consider this term. So our proof we have just calculated as integration of 0 to infinity d by x e raised to x plus e raised to minus x the whole raised to n dx is nothing but 1 by 4 beta of n by 2 comma n by 2. So this is our proof we have just calculated, and we have to calculate integration of 0 to infinity sec hyperbolic x the whole raised to it dx. So this is sec hyperbolic x, and this term is not matching with e raised to x term. So what we are going to do? What is cos hyperbolic x? It is e raised to x plus e raised to minus x upon 2. What is 1 upon cos hyperbolic x? It is nothing but sec hyperbolic x. So 1 upon this term, that is 2 e raised to x plus e raised to minus x. We have sec hyperbolic x the whole raised to 8. So this thing the whole raised to 8. So this sec hyperbolic x the whole raised to 8 can be replaced by this term. So we have integration of 0 to infinity 2 raised to 8 upon e raised to x plus e raised to minus x the whole raised to 8 dx. We can take this 2 raised to 8 outside, so we have the integration of only this term. Okay, but now if you compare this equation with this equation, both these equations are similar. In our case, n is 8. So this is nothing but 1 upon 4 beta of n by 2, that is n by 2 is 4 beta of 4 comma 4. So 2 raised to 8 upon 4 into beta of 4 by 4 is nothing but gamma of 4 into gamma of 4 upon gamma of 4 plus 4, that is gamma of 8. And we know that gamma of n is nothing but n minus 1 factorial when n is an integer and n is greater than 0. So it will be nothing but 2 raised to 8 upon 4 into 3 factorial upon 7 factorial. So when we solve this, 2 raised to 8, 4 can be written as 2 square. So 2 2's can be cancelled from here. So here we have 2 raised to 6. So 2 raised to 6 into 3 factorial is 3 into 2. 3 into 2 upon 7 factorial is 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2. So 3 into 2 will get cancelled. Here 2 raised to 6 is nothing but 64. So 16 upon 7 into 5, that is 35. So our I1 is 16 upon 35. So this integration is nothing but 16 upon 35. So this is our final solution, and this is how we solve the problem on beta and gamma function. More such problems we will see in our next video. So stay tuned for our future lectures.